Hey guys, welcome back to the channel Opinions Matter. And you guys have already saw a lot of videos and everything. Well, this video is going to be the Osmo Pocket with the custom rig that I just built. The problem with Osmo Pocket sometimes I feel is that in low light it gives you lot of grains. So we are going to solve that problem. So get excited to see a very new performance on the Osmo Pocket with that light. So what we are going to do is that we are going to toggle and give out our experience by building this custom setup.
Alright guys, so for this setup on your Osmo Pocket, which is out here, you will require something called a polarpro grip. So make sure you guys are buying this polarpro tripod mount. Now the good thing about this tripod mount is that you can mount in two ways. So you have a tripod mount adapter out here, and then you have another mount out here also. After that, when you have bought this tripod mount adapter, all you need to do is that install this tripod mount adapter going like this, okay, and then you just simply clamp onto it. Once it's done, you will see that now you cannot put the Osmo Pocket inside the DJI case, right? So we'll try to install this inside the DJI case. You will see that it doesn't fit the DJI case because it's now a little bit bigger than it's supposed to be, right? So for this, if you guys are willing to purchase, you can buy this. Link will be in the description. Otherwise, what I do is that you can buy this for like real cheap. You do not need to go for any specific company. This is just a case that comes for like a dollar or so. They're trying to oversell this online for $9. But I went and bought a PGY Tech because I believe in this company, PGY Tech. And this is the whole kind of setup. Now, the thing is that I was talking about the light, right? So you can get this light, which I use for a lot of my video equipments. So I use this one, which is like a lume cube. And a lume cube has a lot of brightness. So what I did was, and it comes with this tripod mount adapter also, so you won't face any sort of problem. This I had to buy separately. These are for like 3 or 4 cents. All you need to do is install this on the side. And now we are going to see how this setup performs compared to in low light when you were using just the Osmo Pocket. Before we begin this video, you saw how the Osmo Pocket was getting a lot of grainy footage, and you might be thinking, I will simply pick this up, turn this into auto, and I'll be good. That is not the scenario at all, because you have to go to manual settings, and I've taken a screenshot of that explaining you the manual settings or the pro settings. In that way, when your light is focused on you, your background will not have grains at all. So let me show you the test, and let me show you what all stuff you need to do after this. And let me show you a test example of how this looks.
Actually, you go into videos, okay? So go into videos, and then you select what sort of quality you need. So I'm going to select 30 FPS. And then you can go out here, select, I won't say FPV, I would say track is fine. And then from there, we will be going into pro mode, okay? So in pro mode, we will be selecting as MP4 because I don't want very big files to cramp up on my iPad. And in pro, we'll be keeping all the white balance and everything to be auto. Color I can keep cine like if you want. You can change that later on. You can go ahead and select this, but in manual, I'm going to stop this and I'm going to show you something. So go get away from auto, go to manual settings, go to ISO 200. And since you have the luxury of shooting at 30 FPS, you can actually put down your shutter speed to be 60, 1 by 60. Do not go to 1 by 50. So double the amount of shutter speed. So sorry, double the amount of frame rate. That will be your shutter speed. So 1 by 60, your negative 3 in your zero exposure. Don't worry on it. You can do a test shot just by turning the camera on the other side. So just turn the camera. Exposure going roundabout a little bit crazy, going to negative 2.3 or negative 3. Okay, now at right now at this position, you will see when you shoot at ISO 200 with the light on, you will see no grains in the background. Is literally no. I think I dropped my Osmo. Now look at this. There is literally no grains in the background. So check the backgrounds. when you saw me walking down in the streets and taking some videos and everything, you saw that there was a lot of grains, right? So this light with these settings, you know, like at very, very, you know, like minimum required kind of settings, even at lower exposure, you will not see any sort of grains, because when you're vlogging, it's all about you and your content and what you're trying to promote. By the way, by doing this test, I have already, there's been a small thing now, which is that I've dropped this Osmo Pocket. If you guys like this video and think that this is super helpful and this rig is a definite recommendation, give me a big thumbs up, like, and do press that subscribe button with some notification bells on. See you again on another episode.